Hey there, Laker fans. It's that time again for another episode of WLKR News. On this week's episode, we will catch up with the most recent accomplishments of the Laker Marching Band, meet another senior, and interview another one of our new teachers at RCHS. But first, our own math department chair, Ms. Pam Wilson, has recently been named one of the 9 finalists for the Ashland Teacher Achievement Award in the state of Kentucky. Reporter Renata Smith caught up with this passionate and caring teacher to find out more about this great honor.
Hey Lakers, I'm Renata and I'm here with Ms. Wilson to ask her about the new Ashland Teacher Achievement Award that she has received. So, what exactly is the Ashland Teacher Achievement Award?
In the state of Kentucky, parents, students, colleagues can nominate teachers, and so last spring I received an email saying I had been nominated, and part of the process, you have 4 essay questions that you respond to that pertain to you as a learner, the teacher, how I continue learning as a teacher leader, how I try to add to our professional community and encourage other teachers, and then just different philosophies and strategies that you use in your classroom. And from I submitted those, and then I had 3 letters of recommendation from administrators, parents, and colleagues that I turned in. And about a month ago, I received an email saying, or a letter in the mail saying that I had been chosen for the top 24. And from those 24, they choose 9, and those 9 teachers are actually observed, and then your top 3 elementary, middle, and high school teachers of the year come from that pool of teachers. Unfortunately, I didn't make the top 9, but I think it's quite an honor just to be named to the top 24.
So as I understand, there's 24 teachers in the whole state, right?
Yes, there are 8 elementary, 8 middle school, and 8 high school teachers that have been chosen for that last 24.
And are there any other specific awards you hope to receive in the future?
I'm still waiting. From a couple of years ago, I was nominated by a former student and their parent for the Presidential Award for Excellence in Science and Math Teaching, and I made the top 5 teachers in math for that, but we are still awaiting, and I mean, it would be a great honor to receive that when I would get a trip to Washington, D.C., but still waiting and don't know anything about that one yet, so.
Well, good luck with that one, and I hope you get it.
Congratulations to Ms. Wilson. What an awesome accomplishment. Next, we'd like to catch up on the recent success of the Mighty Laker Marching Band. In the last several weeks, the Marching Band has participated in 5 competitions. They have earned 3 second place awards, 2 first place awards, while percussion has gone undefeated this season. In the region, the band finished 2nd to Adair County by only 1 point. This weekend, the band will participate in the state semifinals at Bourbon County, hoping to advance to state finals at EKU. We'd like to wish you the best of luck this weekend. Now it's time to catch up on the most recent fall Laker sports news. Here is sports reporter Macy Preston with all the scores and stats.
Good afternoon, Laker fans. The Mighty Laker football team had a victory 2 weeks ago against Clay County with an overall score of 45-20. The Mighty Lakers managed 487 yards of offense, including 400 yards rushing and 87 yards receiving. On the ground, Braxton Mann carried 15 times for 142 yards and 2 touchdowns. Brandon Meyer carried 5 times for 127 yards and 1 touchdown. And Jordan Ratcliffe carried 18 times for 85 yards and 2 touchdowns. In the air, Tristan Coffey caught 2 passes for 80 yards. Last Friday, the Mighty Lakers fell short against Knox Central with an overall score of 12-41. The Lakers managed only 125 yards of offense, including 80 yards rushing and 45 yards receiving. Passing was Braxton Mann with 12 attempts for 45 yards and 1 touchdown. On the ground, Jordan Ratcliffe carried 10 times for 80 yards, while in the air, Tristan Coffey caught 2 passes for 23 yards. Good luck to the boys as they face Grayson County this week in the final regular season game. The Lady Laker volleyball team finished off this season in the semifinals of the regional tournament. They won their 3rd district tournament in a row and proceeded to the regional tournament in Bowling Green. Monday night, the Lady Lakers easily defeated Franklin Simpson in the first round, but fell short Wednesday night against Greenwood. Congrats, volleyball team, on a successful season. The cross-country team went to Mercer County last week with a total of 18 teams. Coming in 2nd for the Lakers was Brooke Hashey with a place of 39. The girls finished as a team in 5th place. Coming in 1st for the boys was Joe Robertson with a place of 35. The Lakers also went to Wayne County this past Saturday for a very hard and cold meet. Coming in second for the girls was Brooke Hashey with a place of 14th. The girls placed 5th overall. For the boys, Joe Robertson finished with an overall place of 27th, while Dante Taylor finished with a place of 35th. Well, Lakers, that's all for this week. And until next time, I'm your sports anchor, Macy Preston, and that's how the Lakers put the anchor down.
You may have seen an unfamiliar face at RCHS. This would be the new math teacher, Mr. Lance Williams. So here again is reporter Renata Smith with more about the new teacher.
Hey, Lakers, I'm Renata, and today I'm here with Mr. Lance Williams. So, where did you previously teach before you came to Russell County?
Somerset Independent School District at Meese Middle School.
And what's the biggest difference between Meese Middle School and Russell County?
Age of students, obviously, and school size.
Was it bigger than Russell County High School or smaller?
Not at all. It's independent district, so it's much smaller.
Gotcha. And what would you like to see happen in the school year?
Snow days.
A lot of snow days?
Lots.
Me too.
For this week's senior profile, you can catch him on the football field, hugging friends in the hallway, or maybe even hear him answering every question in history class. Here's reporter Grant Best to give us a better look at this classy Southern gentleman, Mr. Dylan Hatcher.
Hello, Lakers. I'm here with this week's senior profile, Dylan Hatcher. Dylan, how's it going?
It's going pretty good.
That's good. So, how's senior year treating you so far?
Well, it's been okay. It's just that this semester all my classes are pretty hard, so I'm really looking forward to next semester.
Yeah. I know that your real name is Dylan, but all your friends call you Patches. Why is that?
Well, it all started the time that Skylar Stapleton saw my big birthmark that covers my whole leg, and he said, from then on, I'm going to call you Patches, and so it started from there.
That's been like 4 years.
It has.
I know that you have been part of a conclusive group that was once known as the RC Mafia. Since that has been eliminated, how has that affected you?
It has not really affected anything at all because it never was anything to begin with. It was just an Instagram page, and we got the good idea to put decals on our vehicles. And, well, I mean, we're still all best friends and still hang out every day, and it really hasn't changed at all.
So when you guys hang out, I know it looks like you guys just sit there, but there's got to be something secretly going on.
Well, I mean, no, not really. We just all like being around each other and then talking to each other all the time, and we just sit and talk, and sometimes we'll go swing.
Nice. I know these past couple years have been pretty wild and exciting, but what has been the best memory?
I would have to say probably the times going to KYA and Kuna, and all the times we got pretty wild there.
Our high school experience, like all great things, must come to an end, but what will you miss most about RCHS?
I guess getting to see everybody and getting to hang out with all my friends, and because I'm sure everybody's going to go their ways, and I say it probably won't ever be the same again, but I guess everything happens for a reason.
True that. Well, there you have it, Lakers. You've found out probably more than you'd like to know about this week's senior profile.
That's about it for this week's episode. We'll be back soon with more on What's Up at RCHS. So until next time, I'm your news anchor, Bailey Brown. See you next time.
Ready?
Yep.
Check, check. 1B down. Dawson, how do you say go in Latin?
Just say go.
All right. Ready, set, go.
It's country, it's not
fair. And, come on.
How did you even get there?
You are.
It's all right. You're doing great. You can do it.
I'm not happy very much. Just let me.
That's so true. I'm not happy very, very many times in my life. Don't ruin this. Let me laugh. Let me laugh. Not me, just them.
All my cheeks hurt.
Hugging friends. Sorry. That just sounds like Elmo.